Item hash, SCP-2289 Object Class, Euclid Special Containment Procedures, SCP-2289-1-7 are to be kept under full biocontainment protocol at Site 66. The facilities must include a litter box and a minimum of 10 sheltered bedding locations, each 1 meter by 1 meter by 50 centimeters, for SCP-2289-1-5, a perch, cuttlebone, and nesting location in the upper half of the containment structure for SCP-2289-6, and a separate room within biocontainment with a closing door, bed, desk, lamp, toilet, and change of clothes for SCP-2289-7. The following food will be made available daily: a carcass of not less than 5 kg lean mass, 500 grams of a mix of small fruit, nuts, and seeds, and a standard daily meal portion, which may be flavored as per SCP-2289-7's wishes from a list of pre-selected choices. Any lack of appetite or difficulty swallowing observed in any organisms within containment must be immediately brought to the attention of Site 66's veterinarian surgeon, who will assess whether emergency ocular removal is necessary. Cleaning of the litter box, carcass bone removal, and general chamber maintenance will be carried out under camera supervision by SCP-2289-7. All waste materials, including sewage, from the biocontainment structure must be incinerated. Any materials removed from the biocontainment chamber not kept in fully sealed transport containers for incineration or testing will constitute a containment breach. The biocontainment chamber will be monitored by no less than 4 cameras at all times, in order to maintain full containment of all organisms within the chamber. SCP subjects may be removed from the chamber for testing only under sedation in fully sealed transport containers by researchers equipped with level 4 biocontainment suits and trained in hostile carnivora capture. Any wounds suffered while handling SCP-2289-1-7 will be brought to the attention of Site 66 officers for medical evaluation. Description: SCP-2289 is a novel strain of devil facial tumor disease, a transmissible cancer endemic in the Tasmanian devil, Sarcophilus harryi, and spread by introduction of infected tissue to skin lesions. SCP-2289's progression is such that multiple metastasizing tumors grow over the infected vertebrate. 85% of the tumors are concentrated on the craniofacial region and the throat, with the remainder dispersed on the skin in other locations. Approximately 2.5% of tumors are expressed on internal organs. Death in the original disease usually occurs due to starvation, as the growing tumors prevent proper feeding over time. SCP-2289 has 3 additional characteristics that has caused it to come to the attention of the Foundation. First, the tumors generate their own fully functional eyes, with ocular eruption occurring between 5-7 days after first appearance of the tumor. This can help to compensate for the fact that the tumors themselves may occlude the natural eyes. Second, SCP-2289 has proven capable of crossing the species barrier, resulting in potential infection of all vertebrates tested to date. Third, all living infected vertebrates are not only capable of seeing through the eyes generated by the tumors, but the eyes on all other infected vertebrates' tumors. The method of the transmission of visual information between infected vertebrates and the range of communication between infected vertebrates has not yet been determined. SCP-2289-1-7 are the present known individuals infected with SCP-2289. SCP-2289-1-5 are Tasmanian devils, 3 female and 2 male. SCP-2289-6 is a scarlet macaw, Aramacau, infected as part of Experiment 2289-D, and held for continued observation. SCP-2289-7 is formerly D-435,966, infected during a containment breach when it was cleaning the SCP-2289 enclosure. All 7 subjects express multiple craniofacial tumors, with ocular eruptions on each tumor. SCP-2289-3 has expressed a tumor and eye on its tail. SCP-2289-7 has a tumor with ocular eruption on its left hand. All neoplastic eyes are of the devil type, even on non-devil species. Addendum, Interview 2289-12 interviewed, SCP-2289-7 interviewer, Dr. Roderick Argent forward, routine interview between Dr. R. Argent and SCP-2289-7. Purpose of routine interviews is to check self-reported health issues in SCP-2289-1-7 between veterinary examinations. Begin log. Dr. R. Argent, good morning, SCP-2289-7. How are you feeling today? SCP-2289-7, pretty good, I suppose, for having a terminal cancer that turns you into a deformed freak. Dr. R. Argent, the tumor on your mandibular alveolar process is not interfering with your feeding habits? SCP-2289-7, eh? Could you repeat that? I'm seeing better than I hear out of my left ear these days. Dr. R. Argent, the tumor on your chin. Is it interfering with your eating? SCP-2289-7, nah, I can eat just fine. Check on Cinco, though. An eye just formed on the back of his throat yesterday. I realized it when he hissed at Yuno. Also, another new eye is dark, mostly. I think it's on Das's liver. Not sure. Dr. R. Argent, thank you, I'll inform the veterinarian and have those looked at right away. I just want you to know that we at the Foundation truly appreciate your cooperation with personnel regarding SCP-2289. SCP-2289-7, hey, it's no biggie. You guys have treated me better than anyone in years, since I got infected. Yeah, I'm still a prisoner and I share my cell with a bunch of devils and a red bird, but Mama always told me I'd end up living with devils, anyway. I mean, yeah, now I gotta stare at Terz's ass all the time, but you guys are doing what you can to keep us alive and comfortable, for the most part. Dr. R. Argent, have you noticed any other senses forming since your infection? More than extra-visual stimulus? Sounds? Smells? Taste? Tactile stimuli? SCP-2289-7, what? Oh, this is going back to the hive mind theory, or like sentient cancer or something. No, I haven't. But like, we are talking about some marsupial wolverines and a bird. I don't think I'd be thinking much more from them but eat, sleep, fuck. I do that, already. Dr. R. Argent, how about thoughts the other way? Can you direct SCP-2289-1-6? SCP-2289-7, huh? You're talking about me getting lost eye blows to do as I say? The hell I can. It's more like we're family, now. All we got is perspective. We know what each other sees. Keeps the aggression down when you gotta watch you hissing at yourself. We all know we're dying. You keep talking about who gets to control who, when all you need is a little compassion, you know. You keep looking for power? Well, this cancer ain't it. Except. Dr. R. Argent, except? SCP-2289-7. Except I'm probably really good at 173 duty now. Dr. R. Argent. Would you, SCP-2289-7, no. End log.